was weird. All of a sudden, my stream just crashed. OBS was like reconnecting in 10 seconds. So thanks, OBS. Let's just have people do the whole thing where they go, "Oh my gosh, did what happened?" And then, like, 2 seconds later, it's like, "Oh wait, you're back on." All right, cool. So where did I leave off? Let's see. I'd like to know where. Let's see. I'd like you to find out where he's stashing his gold. If you can, I'll give you a share of the wealth. Are you up for it? I'll do it. All right, excellent. Here's what I want you to do. I'm not sure where he goes, but he wanders around town at night. Watch his movements. The best vantage point is on top of the lighthouse south of town. That will give you a nice view of Sadenine. If you keep an eye on where he goes, I'm sure you'll figure out where he's hiding that gold. Sweet. Awesome. So, of course, we're going to do the most cost-effective thing, which is going to be not actually returning the gold to that guy. Early game, some of the stuff's very, well, you min-max Morrowind as much as you can when it comes to gold, because friggin' A. Stuff is expensive. So let's do that quest. We are gonna have to wait till nighttime. Gosh, it is quite dark in here. Wow. I'd love to get in that chest, but I'm pretty sure. Oh. She doesn't see me. Oh yeah. Let me do a new save. Dratha. Okay. This is also a game we can quick save, which is awesome. As opposed to my Fallout 4 series, which that wasn't a thing. All right, let's see. Eventually, I'm going to want to buy. Ah, there we go. Ooh, a steel Tonto and some gold. All right, awesome. That worked out well. I think also, yeah, sweet, unarmored increased. Right, what else can we get here? Nothing in the barrels, but you can take the travel lantern. What? All right, so we have to wait for Fargoth. So I think, yeah, just go T and wait for, let's see, it's 12. Wait for 11 hours. Oh my gosh, it saves. Oh my gosh, it's freaking pitch black. Oh my. That is super dark. Oh, you can see him though, because he's wearing, or he's using a torch. Is so dark. I can't wait to just do my whole like gain the gold thing from this area and then just go mental. I think you can actually get your first home here if you want to. Alright, sweet. So we visited his little hiding spot. There we go. Alright. Now, I'm gonna try it. This is the whole like. Gonna try to get stuck in the tree. It might have worked a tiny bit. People see me, so it's not like I'm hiding anything. Here we go, we get the engraved ring of healing. Ooh, nice. Another journeyman's lockpick. Another 300 gold. Sick. Wait, what? Let me see. Nice, Vakora, nice. Alright, it is actually quite dark. I'm not sure if I want to go adventuring like this. Let's wait till it's a bit brighter out. I may have to readjust the graphics so it's not as dark. Because we actually need to, you know, see things. Oops. Like, in the ground. There we go. An overcast day. Alrighty then. I'd like to hit a few places before we sort of leave here, and we could always do, like, some interesting stuff. That's pretty funny, Bagora, awesome. Alright, let's see. Whoops, I didn't equip my... Oh wait, did I even buy... I didn't even buy arrows. Lol. That's not very helpful at all. Alright, let's head back. Crap. I think there's a slaughter fish in the water. Ooh. Wow, that did a lot of damage to me.
Yeah.
Freaking kill stealer. Damn it! He stole my kill. Are these? Oh well. Oh cool. I don't actually have to loot it then. Throw your bow at it. Oh, that's cool. I can just take those things. Awesome. All right. Let's barter again. Let's see. Got a few more things for you. Alright, travel lantern. Alright, and should we just get, like, let's just get 100 chitin arrows so I don't have to worry about it. And let's grab, like, a few more gold. I don't want to go overboard. Nice. And he likes me better because of it. Excellent. Take them and equip them. Let's also equip our ring. Sweet. Let's equip that on our magic too. Alright. Now we're ready for adventure. Oh boy. What a way to start. Going out with absolutely no arrows. Alright, let's see if we can take out a mud crab. Oh, we can! Sweet! I mean, you know, mud crabs really aren't anything to be celebrating about, but it's good to know that, you know, our build works. What the hell is that over there? Yes, the physics of Morrowind, where you just weirdly slide down rocks occasionally. Yes, acrobatics is definitely going to be useful, and I need to train some more. Oh gosh! Wow, this thing hits hard. I mean, it's a freaking rat. There we go. Dispose of corpse. And let's definitely use our ring here. Wait, what? Oh, shit. It has the cooldown thing? Alright, I have to write a note here. I forget if that's a patch or something like that, but let me do this then. Let's see. Get rid of... magic item cooldown. I mean, maybe it's cool, but at the same time, it's like basically an FU. Remember when you could just auto-cast it, like, all the time? No, that's not the case anymore. Great. Oh! Interesting. Oh, darn it, not another one. That actually worked. Nice. I fell in the water. Alright, where's that rat at? Whoa! Landslaughter fish, no! Oh gosh, it's on land. No! Come on, you rat. There we go. Woo! And there's some, like, land slaughter fish I have to watch out for right there. How did she even get on land? Well, it's Morrowind, so... Yeah, it just happens, really. See you. Let's try to get a stab in here. There we go. And then we got this guy, Procius Vitellius, who's got a tax record, 200 gold, and some clothes, and I'll just leave them on him. Alright, cool. Alright, let me see if we can't harvest a clam. I gathered a pearl! It's awesome early game. Oh gosh, things are after me. Yeah, I know, right? That is one of the things that some people, like, are extremely frustrated about Morrowind, is, like, I can't hit a slaughterfish on land with a sword, right? You are one of those people. I know, right? That's why I want to raise agility high, so that this doesn't become a terrible issue. Plus, we should definitely raise our short sword up. Now, I don't know why these aren't connected to the ground. Oh, gosh, our first cliff racer. That's not usually a place that we find, but I guess I have a mod installed that adds that location. Okay. Is there a reason I'm not sneaking? Also, let's heal up first. All right. Nice. I think he's stuck on a twig. This is excellent news. Nice. Oh, he's not dead yet. There we go. Nice. Corpse. There we go. Oops. Oh gosh, what is it now? A freaking slaughterfish, maybe? Yep, it's like a tiny little slaughterfish. Gosh, two of them! I love that these fish are so ballsy, they will just attack anything in the water. There we go. So we take all those things. I think pearls are worth a decent amount. Now, I do not know, like, which mod this is from at all. Bitter Coast Cantina. I think maybe it's Farp's weapon mod? Maybe. I don't know for certain. Alright, well, let's definitely talk to this guy, see what he has to
offer.
What's
this about?
Kling Clang. I don't know you, what do you want? Alright, well, he sells spells. Let's see. Fortify Fatigue. Greater Heal Companion and Enrichment. Interesting. Not the best. How about, what do you have? Okay, you've got, like, some interesting things here. You've got a Bone Mold Longbow. You know what? I'm gonna avoid this area, actually. Because this isn't vanilla. And I'd rather be vanilla, actually. I don't know where this thing comes from. If it is from the Farp's weapon mod, then I'm gonna get rid of it, because I'd rather not have it. So yeah. Screw that place. It seems to be, I mean, granted, we're gonna come across other things later on that seem very overpowered, considering, like, what they sell, but usually that's from, you know, gold collecting and whatnot. Alright, so there's a temple right around here. I always like to hit up these two temples. So let me actually wait until healed. And we could always get attacked. Rest has been interrupted. Now we could also get diseases, but because we're a wood elf, we're like 75% less likely. Nice, short blade increased. Alright, let's quick save. Alright, I'm gonna try to do this sneakily. Oh gosh, it's pretty dark. I won't be able to hit that guy, because I don't have silver arrows, nor do I have an enchanted bow. So I'm going to have to use a short blade. Already up an attack, though. They don't see me so far. Interesting. I might... Whoop! Oh gosh. This might not be something my character can do. I did block there, that was nice. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Why isn't my high agility helping me? Oh gosh. Nope, we gotta head out of here. Actually, let's just go to the quick save. Nope, can't do that one. We can fight skeletons, probably. Maybe. I don't know. It could be something we have to return to later. Alright, I think I'm nope. There we go. Alright, cool. Okay, I have to write, like, two more notes to myself here. So, let me see. Let's see. Okay. Cool. Just want to write myself a few notes for things I wanted to fix there. I'm gonna ignore that place entirely. Cause it's not part of the original game. And I realize I do have a mod that adds the rest of Morrowind, but I wouldn't consider that lore friendly, since it basically... It's basically like a thing that sells like a whole bunch of enchanted items really early game, and you can easily steal a lot of stuff from there too, so I'd rather not even have to deal with that. Alright, well let's raise our short blade up with these lower level creatures. So at the very least, like, we need to be able to hit them more, and the higher our skill is, the easier it will be to hit creatures. Chris, you get the nice scream too, which is awesome. Alright, dispose of corpse. Nice. And there's actually a good ring in this ancestral tomb. So let's quick save and check that out. Get some scrolls here too. Excellent. That is woe upon you and Daedric. Don't really need that. Oh, crap, are you kidding me? It's not a skeleton. Oh, and I can't switch. Weapon has no effect. I want to try to get this. Ow. I mean, I'm trying to hit a ghost, too. When you think about it, that is a pretty difficult thing to try and be, you know, attacking. We are low on health. Hey, light armor increased to 46. Gosh, if we can actually kill one of these things, that'll be an accomplishment. Holy crap. Oh gosh, he actually downed me. I think my, gosh. Come on, I need to land a hit! Holy crap. Hey, despite the fact that that weapon was not effective, the arrow did actually stick. That's nice. Looks like nothing else is here. We can donate. Let's get some restoration here. Oh, I thought that would also increase my health. Whoops. Hey, a petty soul gem, I'll take it. Scroll of Hellfire. Oh gosh, that one's a bit harder to read for me. That's stood. And... I think that's fire. Open stone. I have to get better out of my Daedric. It's a little rusty at the moment. What's this one? Fortify Magicka. Okay. I'm not wasting any more gold on that, because apparently none of those restore my health. Alright. That one's an archer. Oh! Wow! Holy crap, that guy wrecked me! That's crazy! Wow! Oh man. Morrowind, it is an unforgiving game sometimes. Alright, let me try this then. Let's get Sanctuary and Shield on us if we can. I think the best thing we should do is wait until healed.
You in?
Oh my gosh!
There is no escape. There is no escape. You Inwa, die.
This is a Dark Brotherhood assassin. Oh, what the hell? Wait, am I sneaking? Why am I running so slow? Oh, there we go. I was gonna say, what the hell? Okay, let me try some spells out here. Oh gosh. I know, this early? What the hell is going on? Damn it, the magic item cooldown. Why? And can we get shield up? Ooh, could we get water walking? Yeah, let's try to do water walking. I think we'll be in a much better position if we can water walk. Failed cast the spell. Where'd he go? Oh, he's stuck up there. Come on. Nice. I think he's stuck, actually. Oh, oh, he's on the move. Oh, oh. Oh, gosh. He's not sure what to do with me right now. Oh gosh! Now he's on my trail. What the hell's happening? I cannot hit this guy. There we go. Oh gosh, I've fallen in the water. Oh gosh, two slaughterfish after me too. Get the hell out of the water. The slaughterfish. Come on. I want to get this kill.
Surrender your life to me, and I will end your pain.
Gosh, if we can get his armor and everything so early on, this would be amazing. I've been fighting this guy for like 2 hours straight now. Oh gosh, I'm stuck. Oh my gosh, we got him. Holy shit. Gosh. Well, rip my arrows. But at the same time, we just got a full set of Dark Brotherhood armor. That is intense. I think most of this stuff is better than chitin. Why did it happen this early on in the game, though? Like, that's crazy. And these are like 15. These are like 46. Hot damn. Oh yeah, that's a huge improvement. Alright, we need to get, like, out of the water. Alright, I gotta make it back to civilization. Holy crap. I can't friggin' believe it. Oh gosh. Can you not? I know, hell yeah, right? Oh gosh, I should probably be a bit more cautious and use my bow here. This playthrough is crazy now! Hot damn! Alright, we gotta make it back home, or else we're gonna have some serious issues. And I cannot be ambushed by anything. Oh gosh, please don't. Oh gosh, I don't have enough magic. Oh gosh, we're gonna need a little bit of, like, a healing spell. Oh gosh, I can't see shit. I've gotta bring up the, oh gosh, no. No! Get away from me! At this point, I'm gonna freaking run out of arrows. There we go. Holy crap. And look at this already! Freaking, this is absolutely nuts. Is there a trigger for the Brother of Steel, or is it just any time you can sleep? Like, that's insane that it happened that early on. Oh gosh, no! No! Ambushed by a mud crab. Morrowind is so deadly. I can't even see it. I'm getting stuck on roots. I've healed a little bit. Oh, did I call it Brotherhood of Steel? I've been playing too much Fallout 4. I can't see him. Shit. I got him! Different Brotherhood, my bad. Alright. Should I sneak? Yeah, I'm glad to be back in Morrowind. Give ourselves a break, right? Oh gosh. Try to be resting. Okay, let's try it. Sweet! Oh, thank goodness. Finally found a spot that was safe enough to do that. Alright, we always gotta hit this guy up. Aw yeah. The Journal of Tarheel. I believe I may have found the correct formula for the spell I'm developing. With it, I'll be able to travel great distances without the need to pay others for the service. And if all goes well, I will test out the new spell tomorrow. I believe I have worked out all the possible complications. It'll allow me to leap great distances, covering many hundreds of miles. Never before has one been able to travel in this manner, vaulting from the ground, sailing through the sky, and without that terrible disorientation of a spell of flying. The time is almost upon me. My research is finished. All of my calculations are checked and rechecked. They laughed at me when I suggested this. We'll see who laughs after I leap to the top of their towers and scream out my success. Oh, Tarheel. That's a short, or that's a long sword, darn it. You're coming for helms and all that stuff. I'm going to dispose of your corpse. No one will know. I could always wear the silly Colobian fur hat. Ho-hee-hee! Look at me. Why? What? Look. It's such a dumb hat. It's such a dumb hat. Alright, well, we got some stuff to sell. Oh my gosh. I can't... We're in Dark Brotherhood armor already. Friggin' A. This is nuts. Oh, from Oblivion Bakura. Yeah, the Crusader's armor is awesome. Now, I actually have a mod installed that will allow us to get a companion, actually. But I think they are behind certain, like, personality things, so I have to, like, raise their speechcraft and whatnot.
I'm a busy gal, so if you could hurry this up.
Gosh, it's all forward of them. Like, I think this guy's... Yes. No, that's Jub.
How do you do?
Oh my gosh, they actually turned Jub into a companion. That's pretty cool. I think normally he's not supposed to be out here. But, like, that lady's a companion. You can basically bring them along with you. They didn't really have a companion system in Morrowind, I'm pretty sure. They would just have people that, like, followed you around during certain quests. Alright, so let's barter. So remember all that chitin armor that you just sold me? Yeah. I found better stuff. Also, extravagant robes and extravagant shoes. Ooh yeah, and the pearl. How much is that? Nice. I should go pearl diving as just part of getting stuff together. What resolution? I'm playing in, let's see. 1240 by 780, I think. Let me double check. I forget the exact number. It's it's 1280 by 720, my bad. Yeah, 1280 by 720 is what I'm playing it. We're using a few different mods. They are listed down below. Morrowind Sound and Graphics Overhaul is like the major one though. It includes, like, a ton of mods. Alright. Now we should probably stick with silver. Hey, Georgie's gone wild. How's it going? Alright. Yeah. It just does more damage, plus it's silver, so... Let's see. And our Scroll of Inkarion Flight. Nice. Alright. I think we're good there. Oh, man, we made some gold back. Excellent. I'm going to need to buy the rest of your chitin arrows, though. Yeah, about that. So, yeah, just in case you're just joining, we literally did our first little venture out from Saidenin. I was preparing for a battle inside an ancestral tomb, and the Brotherhood of... The Dark Brotherhood attacked me already, so now... I'm set with a full set of Dark Brotherhood armor. So, yeah. Oh yeah, the landscape upgrades are fantastic, and just the graphics and everything. It makes it so awesome. No, not the Morog Tong. The Dark Brotherhood. The Dark Brotherhood attack you as part of the quests for the Tribunal expansion. Yeah, they just stab you for eternity, right, yeah. So I was basically like, I lost like probably half of my arrows, 50 of my chitin arrows, just attacking one guy. And it got dangerous, like I was on a sliver of health at one point. Like that was really nasty. But I mean, it's great because we use light armor and we have like fantastic armor now. I know, I'm until I get over the whole, yeah, Brotherhood of Steel thing, it's, yeah. I might call them Brotherhood of Steel by accident instead. Granted, we shouldn't be mentioning them unless... It's Fallout Wind, yeah, right.
Oh, darn it.
You seriously gonna, like, haggle me?
Damn it.
There we go. Lost a bit of persuasion there, but that's okay. We have 900 gold. 900 gold. There we go. Yeah, let's repair some stuff too, shouldn't we? Definitely my chitin bow. Sweet. Let's repair that. Good. Anything else that really needs to be repaired? This gauntlet. And my silver short sword. That's good enough. Sweet. Yeah, like, we might actually be set until we need to get glass armor, which is pretty crazy considering this is literally the first day of our first playthrough. Like, is there actually, like, a, like, it's just, like, yeah, like, an hour and a half in. A little bit less. I actually started a bit late, but still.
If there is
Holy
anything
crap.
I can do, I am humbly at your service.
Alright, sweet. Now then, it's weird. You're really weak in the beginning in Morrowind, so it's kind of difficult to deal with. Oh, you know what? I need to remember that Lover's Kiss is a thing. I need to remember that, or else it's just going to be a horrible thing. So, I don't know, I think we should just follow this trail, because all those things that we tried to fight earlier were extremely difficult. Are you someone who actually lives in town? You are, actually. Like, I'm fairly certain, like, a lot of the areas we probably can't do early on. At least, like, I've tried the ancestral tombs around here, and they're nails. Hmm, interesting. Cool, Georgie, awesome. Alright. I guess let's go in here. We'll have to see how that goes. That's awesome. So to make Skyrim have more Morrowind influence. I like that. You get a lot of assets from the Dragonborn DLC, which is pretty cool. Alright. We are an assassin now. I mean, this is the Arcane Assassin series. I already have Dark Brotherhood armor. This is pretty nuts. Nice! Good to hear a nice you Enwa right in the beginning. Alright, I'm gonna use Sanctuary. Good, I'm a little harder to hit. I need to keybind those. I think I'm better off using my bow, actually. Oh, gosh. Nope. They are too hard to hit. Yeah, we're gonna load. Yeah, those things are really difficult. Oh, that's weird. That was weird. The screens were different. Weird. Oh, interesting, Georgie. Nice. That sounds awesome. All right. So, let's not do those, because holy crap. I need to level up my short blade and my longbow a bit more, as well as my sneak. Now, I'm fairly certain that this guy here, he's Slushy Master. Oh gosh, Slushy. Now, I'm pretty sure that I have enough gold on me that that guy's actually a highwayman. That makes sense, Georgie. Awesome. That's pretty cool. Gosh, he's using his Nord abilities. I think we got him. His agility seems to be pretty low. Nice. Yep, Bandit Brigand. Alright, awesome. Oh, yeah, those are my kite and arrows. I'm like, he came with kite and arrows! No, those are mine. Nice. Hey, Lols Boys. No, Lols Boys. I'm going for probably another hour or so. But yeah, let me see. Oh yeah, more chitin stuff. Ooh, a chitin shield. I think that's better than the Netch shield, right? Nice, it is. Awesome. You know what? I'll take everything. Sweet. Now granted, we were able to pick that guy off from a distance. Oh wow, you can actually see the signs now. That's kind of cool. Now, you know what's interesting is this is going to be a little bit different now. I normally play the game as someone who uses heavy armor and like hammers. Yes, this is modded. This is pretty heavily modded. There's only 10 mods below, but Morrowind Sound and Graphics Overhaul adds so much, it's like 70 mods in one, almost. Yeah, the mods are listed below. Yeah, they're pretty awesome. But this is weird. I'm not actually familiar, or at least it's gonna take me a little bit to remember where, like, certain bows and good armor are, because normally I focus on heavy armor and blunt weapons. Now, he has a paralysis spell. But I think Scribs are fairly easy to defeat. Nice, I resisted magic. Alright. When there are creatures of low level, I'm going to try to take advantage of it, and I'm going to use a short sword. Ooh, nice! I might be able to get some pearls. Let me see. Didn't gather anything useful. Damn. Pearls are such a nice way to get early game gold. Damn it! I almost had that sneak attack. Well, actually, if you've noticed, I actually have a mod that that retextures the scamp. It's pretty awesome. Yeah, right, Lols Boys? It's so true. There's like the Quama Warriors are the only things that attack you in the Quama Mines. But really, I don't know. I always find Quama Mines to be a little bit like... Why would you even care about Quama Mines? Oh, crap, I should have snuck. I gotta get used to sneaking with this character. Just for experience. Try pickpocketing the mud crab. Nice, my larder armor increased. Come on! I didn't have like an 85 agility just to be swinging wildly at things. Do mud crabs even have pockets? Just like stuff it under its shell or something. Alright, Let's give it a go. Might as well. I mean, maybe these humans are a little less powerful. Oh, that is a person right effing there. I didn't even friggin' see them. Now, what is so weird... Oh, wow! That person doesn't see me. Oh, that's so cool! My sneaking is working. There's also the mud crab vendor. I guess you could pickpocket him. Yeah, wow, this sneaking is working out really well. Nice. I mean, I'm not getting tremendous damage. Oh gosh, she sees me now. Got her. Actually, we gotta take everything. Oh, crap, I'm over-encumbered. Let's see here. We can probably drop, like, pants. Oh gosh, we need to drop a little more than that. I mean, I could just drop stuff on in the front of here as well. Which leather boots? Alright. It's a lot of arrows. Hey, Dagoth. Yeah, yeah, I'm playing Morrowind again, right? Oh, gosh. Oh, thanks for the follow, Dagoth, the Charmet. Thank you. Alright. A new follower thing, too. This sounds a little bit quieter for some reason. Well, that person sees me. I think she just used her racial thing.
This is the end of you, Swit!
Yeah! I worked on that today. Oh crap, I'm gonna die, aren't I? I think it's a little too early for me to be- Yeah, it's a little too early for me to be taking on these people. Darn. I need to crank up the volume on that follow alert, though. Actually, George, you mentioned that. I actually have... We could go back and grab that thing. So I have a companion mod actually activated. So I could technically... I think there's one you can get early on that's a Gwar, and I could have a Gwar follow me around. I'm not sure what, like, the detection on that guy is, though, so we'll have to see. Yeah, right. Begins a dungeon over encumbered. What could go wrong? Alright. Oh, I missed. We actually hit a little bit to the right. Ooh. Got him. Loading screens are nice, right? Nice. Get my arrows back. You have to, like, re-equip them, though. They don't do that by themselves. Which is alright, I suppose. Already in Dark Brotherhood armor. This friggin' game sometimes. Now, one thing I'm going to want to invest in early magic-wise is I really, really need... Oh, gosh. Is that another freaking bandit highwayman? Holy crap. Just another freaking bandit. All right, come on. No, I'm not going to give you the gold. Goodbye. That is, I guess I just have so much gold to begin with that, like, there's gonna be bandit highwaymen, like, everywhere. Oh gosh, he's coming closer. Stagger him. There we go. Come on. He's a Nord, so he's got a lot of strength behind him. Doesn't help that he just cast Woad too.
I'll wait you.
Actually, yeah, he has to be in order, or else he wouldn't be able to cast that spell. There we go. Right, what do we got here? It's an Iron Gladiator sword. That's kind of cool. I'm gonna leave him here for the time being. Oh yeah, Lost Boys. No, yeah, that totally happens. If you, like, I remember my first time playing Morrowind. I mean, it does take getting used to the fact that sometimes your blade or your arrows do not connect immediately, and it is really based on chance and calculations. And yeah, it does get a bit freaky sometimes. All right, but I was gonna say that one of the things I want to invest in very early on is some sort of, there we go, friendly beast noises. Follow me. Nice. So now, we have a companion named Peep. This is from the, I think it's called the Companions mod, I believe. So Peep is gonna be basically like a person to carry all my stuff for me, which is awesome. I don't know, like, what kind of health Peep has or anything like that. But hey, we have a Gwar companion to help us carry our stuff. Sweet. Okay, good. He didn't... All the mud crabs respawned, but he didn't respawn. Things are pretty crazy here. Alright, Peep. Companion chair. Yeah, Lulz boys. I love that, finding that guy. Alright, you have your own Gwar. Oh my gosh, your carry weight, sir. Yes, please. Oh wait, that's mine. My bad. Actually, let me, make this menu a little larger so I can see stuff a bit better. And Peep, your menu needs to be a little larger too. Peep? There we go. Oh gosh, yeah, there's some parts in this game where you can definitely save at a very inopportune moment. Definitely. Actually, you know what? Some of these pants I might want to use. Take one, and then you can take these clothes. The sixth house wants to know what you do when you're not in Vardenfell. I play some different games, actually. I've been playing, oh gosh, what have I been playing for a long time? I've been playing a lot of Fallout 4 recently. I think I did all the Fallout, like, well, not all of them. I did Fallout 3, Fallout New Vegas. I've been playing Fallout 4 recently. There's a lot of other games I've been playing too, like, Legend of Grimrock, a whole bunch of other crazy things. Oh, yeah, follow me. Yeah, there's been a huge collection of games. Darkest Dungeon. Well, I got salty about that one. But yeah, a lot of games have happened since my Morrowind. Right, Pelagiad is right over here, so I'm probably going to sell my stuff in this town. Okay, no problem. We grabbed a companion named Peep. He's a Gwar. He has an obnoxious amount of carry weight, and he's gonna help us. Yeah, and banished, and yeah. Nice. Alright. Is there a guy outside or not? Peep. Peep's the best. Does Peep go inside buildings? Peep goes inside buildings. Sweet.
Can we hurry this along?
I'm sorry, I put a guar in your building. I can't. Oh, you're a companion too. There's a lot of companions, damn. Oh, gotcha. Oh, what I do outside of gaming. Let's see. Let me companion share. Outside of gaming. I mean, like, I guess background a little bit. I graduated from college, like, 2 years ago or something. And I've been doing, like, jobs here and there. Nothing related to the field I'm interested in. But, yeah. I basically, like, for the longest time, I was actually working and then doing this at night. But yeah, so that's basically what it is. I'm recently just searching for a different kind of job related to my field, which is, like, environmental science and stuff like that. And nature in general. And yeah, so that's pretty much what I'm up to. Work and or looking for work. Yeah, he doesn't even bat an eye that Peeps in his house, right? Alright, I got some stuff to sell. Alright, follow me. Oh, whoops. I'm so over-encumbered, I can't actually talk to you. It's a little annoying. If Peep ruins someone's boots, yeah, right. Alright, I have to move all this stuff at least a tiny bit closer. There we go. Unlike other games, you just stop moving altogether. Alright, let's barter. Now, I'm interested to see what this guy has. Oh gosh! He's got darts. Darts are very interesting because they work a little bit different than normal bows. So it'd be quite interesting to use those. Alright, but let's sell what we have here. Keeping that. Selling the extra chitin boots. We have really min-maxed our stuff here, which I'm enjoying tremendously. The fact that we have, like, 900 gold right now is just friggin' amazing. Alright. I think I might have to worry about Peep being attacked by monsters, so I'm gonna have to be careful when I save. And, make sure that he's not, like, under attack. So that will be an issue. I'll probably, like, have Peep, like, in whatever house we end up, like, in. But we're going to have to choose somewhere else to, or someone else to actually bring with us. Alright, so far that's the best short sword we can have. I don't think we're even gonna need light armor for the longest time. I guess we just get as much gold as we can for this small amount. I try to like raising it by 5 each time. That seems to be decent. Now, we could... Like, our character, like, we are an assassin, we are a thief, too. We could totally just, like, see what's in here. Them 3D graphics, though. Common cyan ring. Now, I believe there's some weird stuff like, this is stealing. I don't think I can open that. Darn. Oh, hi, how's it going? Nothing to report here. Alright, Peep, let's get... Oh, I accidentally dropped some other kite and stuff. Peep, you're actually a little bit large to have inside of a building. I'm just gonna be straight honest with you. I'm not calling you fat, I'm just saying you probably should wait outside. Oh yeah, Dagoth. Oh my gosh, yeah. Buying the pack rat from Mournhold and realizing, oh crap, people attack that thing too. It is awful. Alright, now I think this guy's an armor. Let's see if he might have like a better bow or something. Oh, we all have good Morrowind massacre stories, don't we? Alright, so... What do you have? Let's see. Doesn't look like much different, really. These are both low. Now it's a little better, but it's not silver, so I'm not going to buy it. Otherwise, I think we're okay. He doesn't really sell anything that way. We could buy some apprentice armor hammers and some repair prongs. In fact, I'm probably going to buy his repair prongs. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Gaynor was crazy. I agree with that. Ooh. There we go. We'll buy some repair prongs just so we can do some repairs on the go. Oh my gosh, Peep, you're actually huge. Oh my gosh, Peep, why? Alright, can we just take a look at... Let me quick save. Just in case this goes down horribly. Now... I am going to try to focus on, we're going to try and focus with this character more on alteration than, using lockpicking. Because lockpicking is very, well, random chance. I like to take the random chance out of Morrowind as much as I can. Wow. You know what? It's 3 gold that I earned. I'll take it. Oh, Peep's trying to get upstairs. Sorry about that. Alright, yes. Cool.
What say you?
I think Peep just teleported. I don't know Dagoth. Oh, and I'll see you in later, Georgie. But yeah, I'm not sure if there's been like a reality mod to add to Morrowind that sort of adds that extra like bit of, you know, you can't do this or that in towns because people notice you. Pelagiad main road, Pelagiad back road. Alright, Belmore. Alright. Sweet. I chose the twisted trees for this playthrough because I thought they were awesome. And do I have to be careful here? Is this a Quama mine or is this another like place where humans live? Because right now I can't take on some of these things. Yeah, I won't be able to take that on, I think. Did you see how slow that was? Yeah, that'd be cool, Dagoth, wouldn't it? Like, people react to everything you do. Oh gosh, Peep, you've actually, like, got me stuck there a little. Oh gosh. Peep? Oh gosh, Peep's attacking or something. Holy shit, Peep. That was incredible. You actually distracted the Quama. Peep's a bro, man. I like Peep. You followed the Yellow Brick Road, right? Oh, we could also get a quest here, I think. From this lady. Hey, Brussels, how's it going? Alright, let's see. I'm begging your pardon. Have you seen a bandit nearby? I must find him. Yes, I was walking along here minding my own business. Suddenly, a bandit jumped at me from behind. He was a dark elf. A strong, dashing dark elf. He didn't harm me in any way, although he did take my jewels. He was quite gentle, and he talked to me for what seemed like forever. Oh, gosh. It is actually evening for me, Brussels. Oh gosh, that's pretty funny, Bakura. That's some enchantments, though. 90% magic and damage reflection. Alright, what's that? Oh, never mind the jewels. I just want to find the bandit again. He was charming and funny, and I simply must see him again. His name? Nelos Onmar. A name that will stay on my lips for eternity. Perhaps you can find him for me. Please, I cannot live without knowing if he could ever love me. I have nothing to offer you in return, but could you not help me for the sake of love? Let's see here. This is the most bullshit quest ever. Let's see. I will try to find this man, if only for love's sake. Alright, you will try? Thank you so. I'm sure you'll be able to find him. He mentioned something about heading north, so I imagine he might be able to find, or he might be found in Pelagiad. Please, if you find him, give him this glove for me, a token of my love. I'm certain he will want to find me again. All right.
How does the day greet you, friend?
So you have to take some lady's glove, because she found love from a bandit who stole her heart. I'll stop. I'll stop. Oh gosh. I think at some point I'm going to have to grab some of these flowers for like a quest. Right? Although I'm not sure. I think I'm going to focus more on the Thieves Guild and Morog Tong than the Mages Guild. Although I might do a bit of Mages Guild just because this character is going to be using magic. He's a smooth criminal. Yeah, here we go. I think Peep killed that. Oh gosh, yeah, right. There's some weird textury stuff going on there. Weird. Ooh. You know what? Is there anyone in s- I don't think I can unlock that. One thing we are going to be doing is basically stealing everything in this game that we can possibly steal. Do you have a trapdoor that leads down to a basement? No? Darn it. I'm sorry, I there's a giant animal in your home. I also can't seem to leave. Follow me. Nope, that's Peep. I need to get out the door. There we go. All right. Hey, athletics increased. That's gonna help.
The prey approaches.
All right, I think he's in here. I haven't much time. Oh, she's a companion too. Sweet. Now, normally,
let's hear it.
if I wanted to make her my companion, you have to do like a conversation, and it's this really tedious, like, let's talk about you, let's talk about mutual interests, let's talk about you, and it like slowly raises their disposition, and then you're like, all right, now we've reached the threshold where we have to now be friends, and then you do friendship things, and then eventually you can have them as a companion. I'd rather just use magic, because it's easier. Let's talk about you! Disposition plus one, so you see how that works. I mean, I guess you could also bribe them. I think there's a lot of... Oh gosh, there's a lot of companions in here.
If you want something, now's the time to talk.
You dance close to the fire, don't you? I know, right? Friggin' this huge, huge guar that just runs in. Let's see. Let's see. What? Come, me? Speak Ashland? Not speak so good, old elf, sorry. Walker, you're also a companion. There's a lot of companions in here, holy crap.
Alright, I'm listening.
Alright, is that the dark elf back there? Yeah, here
what
he is.
What say you?
Alright. Nari's glove. Oh gosh, Brussels. Let's see. That's called, I think it's Moon Sugar in this game, or Skooma. Probably Skooma. Let's see. You have what? How odd. She was a lovely young woman. But what would she want with a rogue like me? She is beautiful, though, and seems sweet. For the first time in my life, I actually felt a little remorse for robbing someone. I should see her again. Here, take this. Tell her, you have a note from Nellos. I must see her again. I won't forget this, friend. Just tell her you have a note from Nellos. Okay, I think she'll be happy with it. Can we read it? Note from Nellos. Truly, I was enchanted with you from the moment I saw you. I beg for your forgiveness for my past transgressions. While I cannot imagine what a woman of beauty and breeding would see in a rogue like me, I thank the gods that you have sent for me. I will come to you as soon as I can. Until then, yours, Nellos.
Quickly, Outlander. I haven't much time.
So many people in here, I actually have to jump over the tables. Where the hell did Peep go? Uh-oh. Oh, there you are, Peep. You following me? Alright, cool, Peep. Come on, let's go.
You like to dance close to the fire, don't you?
Oh, never get tired of that. Some of the things that they say, it's just, even though
make
it's like
it quick, Outlander.
You know, the sort of canned, like, you know, this is the stuff that happens when you're within like 5 feet and they say to you, it's still great. Alright. So we gotta find that lady again. Now, Morrowind is a game that has no quest markers. And occasionally, you will come across a quest that tells you the wrong cardinal direction. Oh shit, what is it? Wow, Peep doing work. Damn, Peep. Peep might be a little overpowered for me right now. Just as a companion. I appreciate the help. Hot damn. Yeah, Brussels. Oh gosh, Peep. Yeah, gathered one pearl. Oh, darn it. I always like getting pearls early game. Actually, pearls anytime are usually a good idea. Any clams? No clams. Oh gosh. The only problem now is I may have lost that lady. She was on a road very similar to this. Like, no? Here? Over. Oh gosh. Stuck on a rock. There you are. Let's see. Note from Nellis. He gave you a letter. He gave you a letter to give to me. Wonderful. Thank you so. I knew he cared. You didn't have to do all this for me. I really appreciate it. You're clearly a wonderful person. You should visit my friend, Bernard Ariel in Telbranora. He's a wonderful person. I think you two would get along famously. Interesting. You know what? I'm gonna write that name down. Is there anything else I can do? No? Is it in my journal?
Greetings.
There we go. What, Slushy? Oh gosh. Okay. Interesting. Alright. So let me write that down, that if we ever are in Telbranora, that I have to go see that guy. Alright, let me see. Oops. I mean, it is in our journal, but our journal is gonna, like, fill up quickly. Alright. Bernard. Ariel. Aureli. Oh gosh, that's pretty funny. Yeah, it's... yeah. Health potions, cool, that's good. I've basically only, almost, the only thing to heal myself is the enchanted ring right now, so that's actually going to be kind of useful. Let's see here. Sweet. Alright, awesome. Quick save. And we'll keep heading to Balmora. Now we have to head down the Foyada to get there as well. Tracks of the Braveheart movie? Nice. Yeah, we have to, some sort of magic that increases our fatigue regeneration, because it is a problem. I don't think we can do it. As much as I want to just plunder every dungeon, Morrowind. Oh gosh, what is it? Crap. Peep, are you trying to attack me? Are you trying to attack me?
I'm waiting.
Weird. Hey, convoy, how's it going? Yeah, Morrowind is a punishing mistress. You can't just go in every dungeon. Hello, please, can you help me? I've lost my way and I cannot find the holy place for which I'm searching. Holy place. Yes, the fields of Camus. I'm on a pilgrimage to the holiest of places, but I seem to have lost my way. Perhaps you can help me find it. Surely you know the area better than I. I can pay you for your time, say 150 septums. Ooh, nice. Alright, I will try to lead you to this place. Alright, see you later, Brussels. Have a good one. Alright, let's see. Thank you so much. I know the fields of Camus are near the water. The view from there is supposed to be breathtaking. I've also been told there's a farm nearby where pilgrims may sometimes stop and rest weary legs. Okay. We're technically under attack right now. I don't know with what, though. Oh, nice, convoy. Awesome. Or at the very least, the attack music is on. Oh! Thank you for the host! Here, wait, let me fix that. But thank you for that. I have to change that menu. It was meant to be just for, follows, not hosts as well. But I guess I could add some hosts as an alert too. I mean, I do see them quite clearly in chat. Follows I don't, so let's see. Yeah. It was meant to be just for follows. I have to change that quickly. Let's see. I discovered Twitch alerts and made custom ones. All right, let's try this again. Let me just see if this works out. Oh, I don't think it shows on the other end. Actually, I'm not sure if it's actually showing. Yeah, let me see here. I don't think it's actually... I have to change that quickly. Let me see. Followers. Properties. Refresh. Oh, let's see here. I think it's this one. Oh, wait. I have to select the region again. Oh, gosh. Really? Like that? I have to make sure I use the right menu or else it's going to be crazy to look at. Okay. Enter. Okay. All right, let me try that again. All right, well, it's definitely working, I think. I mean, from my side at least. All right, I think we're good. Sweet. I'll have to refine that a bit, but I have to make sure to have the window only do follow alerts. Oh, it's Cliff Racer.
Die, Victor.
Thank you, Convoy. That's awesome. There we go. Finally hit it. Oh, gosh. Now to begin its slow descent. Yes, I use the Moobot, or at least I use the Moobot chat application. I'll be honest, I don't know what the hell I'm doing when it comes to, like, Twitch alerts and stuff like that. Oh, really interesting. Huh, alright, I'll have to check that out tomorrow. He is really making a slow descent. Come on, you bastard. There we go. Now, how many arrows did I put in you? Like, 6. Jeez. Oops. I meant to take that one, too. There we go. How old is the series? It just started today, actually. It just started today. I was playing Fallout 4. Yeah. Basically, we're putting it on hiatus until about, like, early August. That way we can do the vault-building DLC and the contraptions DLC together, and then get into Nuka World shortly after, as opposed to having about 2 months of me stretching out gameplay until Nuka World. So, yeah, this just started today, which is crazy because we already got attacked by a Dark Brotherhood assassin, killed it with a sliver of health left. And yeah, it's been a wild ride for just the first episode. All right. So far this has been running pretty well actually. I'm wondering if maybe it'd be a good idea to like raise the draw distances and stuff like that. That'd be pretty cool. Okay. I think that's a bandit highwayman. He seems to be in that right area. He seems to be in the right area. I'm going for it.
This is the end of you, sweet.
Oh gosh, Peep. Did Peep just kill him?
Nice, they're tanking him. He might also kill that lady.
Right,
I'm gonna try to not waste so many arrows. Oh gosh.
Die, Fletcher.
Oh gosh. He is really hard to hit.
You're beaten.
I thought with an agility of 85, we'd at least be like hitting things a little more often. Damn. Alright, seems like we're better off using a bow. Ow. Nope, I think I might die here. Oh gosh, stuck on a rock. Yep, probably gonna die here.
Your life is approaching.
Really, MGSC breaks your game for some reason. MGSO, yeah. Did you know that, one thing I found out recently is that, Morrowind Sound and Graphics Overhaul has an outdated version of the Morrowind Graphics Extender. So one thing I had to do today was, actually download the new version of the, Morrowind Graphics Extender, because before you couldn't even have a windowed version, or you couldn't have a bordered window version. So I was stuck with having Morrowind borderless in the center of my monitor, which is really annoying. I'd rather have it in like the left-hand corner so I can see chat and all my other notes and things below it. All right, well, I mean, we could attempt this again and just keep our distance, because apparently that's the only way we can actually win this battle. Nice, we actually got two hits on the guy.
Die, Fletcher.
Gosh, they're both using the sanctuary spell for that come to dark elves. Nice! Oh, talk you through MGSO. MGSO takes a while to set up. I'm just letting you know now. Like, it's a process. Like, the first time I did it, it took me a couple hours. Like, 2 hours to set up. It's a huge process. It has to, like, do all kinds of patches and stuff. But I could walk you through it. Most of the stuff is, does put you through some sort of instruction when you do Morrowind Sound and Graphics Overhaul. The thing I was talking about? That's not difficult at all. In fact, if you have... Okay, cool. So what you do is you would set up Morrowind Sound and Graphics Overhaul first. Then, once that's installed... Let me actually post the link for you. Yeah, because... It's included in Morrowind Sound and Graphics Overhaul, but it's not actually updated. So that kind of sucks. But let me find the site for you. So, let's see. Top files. So you are looking for... Oops, where the hell? There it is. This is what you're looking for. And, yeah, Morrowind Graphics Extender is what it's called. Might be. But yeah, so, it's been updated recently, and it has much more options than it used to. Oops. Did I accidentally take my boots off? Ball. Alright, let's also save, since we actually got that guy. Yeah. Basically, what you would do is, once you have the Sound and Graphics Overhaul installed, you can just basically copy and paste the contents of that mod and paste it right on top of all the old stuff, and it should work fine. Alright, so I think if we just follow this road, we're gonna come across a farm near the water. Morrowind gets kind of dark sometimes. Is it like seriously dark for you guys? Because I can I can try and work on, like, I think the realistic lighting mod's on right now. And it takes into account, like, if there's absolutely no, places nearby, of light, so, like, no lanterns, it will make, like, certain sewers pitch black. I can change that if that's an issue. Oh, yeah, yeah, go ahead and steal my mod list. There are some things that I might be changing. I think that's a pilgrim. I think one of the mods actually adds stuff that's kind of unlore friendly, so I might change that. Oh, yeah, it's a pilgrim. And this is... Oh, Fields of Camus Shrine! Awesome. So here in the Fields of Camus, Vivek acted as a beast of burden to a poor farmer who could not harvest muck sponge after his guar died. I think there are offerings you're supposed to do with these. Like, I think you're supposed to give muck sponge. Is that lady still following me, by the way? There's Peep. Did the lady die? Uh-oh. There you are. There you are. For a second, I thought I lost her. Oh, gotcha, gotcha. Morrowind, I find, is probably the easiest thing to mod ever, because I literally just drag and drop into data files, and it works fantastic.
What is this about?
Oh, oh crap. Oh my gosh, it's a Kigaudi. I may die to this thing. Oh my gosh, there's two Kigaudis. Oh my gosh. Morrowind, everybody. It doesn't care what level you are. Kigaudis are gonna kick your ass. Holy crap. Wait a second. I'm pretty sure that's a brigand as well. And he just respawned.
It's about time I had some fun.
Yeah, it's a bandit. Oh gosh, he's a giant freaking axe. Get away from me.
This is the end of you, Swit. Now you
please
die.
Do not kill that lady. Alright. So yeah, by the way, all these guys are basically coming out of nowhere, because I have a tremendous amount of gold for this early game. And essentially, like, these places are just, like, areas where these guys will just appear. Ooh, I like these common pants. I will take them from a dead man and use them. That's not creepy, right? And how's this common shirt look? Aw, that common shirt! Aw, man, we are swaglicious right now. That's what I'm talking about. Also, dispose of the corpse and give it all to Peep. Oh my gosh, Conway, that's hilarious. Yep. That means something completely different. Oh yeah, what is it? It's a shame there's no, like, quick- OH GOSH! My friggin' Fallout action figure just fell. Stop it! This is Morrowind! You're not even supposed to be here! There's a gun back in his hand? Come on! I'll deal with you later. Do you mean the code patch? Because the code patch adds a ton of patches to the game that change stuff from like weights and enchantments of arrows to like encumbrance and damage with hand-to-hand combat. Like there's a lot of stuff. Are you talking about that? Also, if you did install MGSO correctly, it should activate all the mods. There we go. Attack on stage. Oh, yes, yes, yes. I know what you're saying. Yeah, when you initially run Morrowind, usually anytime you add a mod, you have to say, like, yes to all or something like that, because it like one by one asks you like, is it okay to play with this, is it okay to play with that, and yes, it activates like a ton of ESPs in that loading bar. Is that what you're saying? Because yeah, that happens. All right, now we have to like get up here and like take a shortcut, because otherwise those Kigaudis are gonna kill me. Or maybe if I talk to that guy, he'll explain how I can get past those Kigaudis. Also, let's quick save since we're close. At least, yeah, okay, cool. So we're all here. Quick save. Away from that spot where the bandits keep going. Let's rest until healed. Sweet. It's not that much brighter up, but we can deal. Let's see if I can't talk to this dude, and maybe he'll tell me, like, how to get past the Kigaudis. I think he mentions that he's like studying Kigaudi mating or something like that. Okay. Hello, please, might you be of assistance? My friend is lost, and I'm very worried about him. Okay, maybe that's not this guy. My friend is Idris Oral, and I were traveling to Vivek, and I heard a strange animal sound nearby. He's sort of an amateur naturalist, and he felt compelled to seek it out. What was making the noise? That was hours ago, and I'm afraid something terrible has happened to him. If you could find him and bring him back safely, I would really appreciate it. I'd go myself, but I'm really more of a scholar than he is. That's why we're traveling together. A little safety in numbers, you know. Can you help? I will try to find your friend. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Truly, I fear for his life. What's UAC for Windows 10? I have no idea what UAC is. I actually run on Windows. What am I running, actually? For a while, I was running Windows 7, actually. Oh, gosh. Now you die. All right. Since the quest lady's tanking for me... Oh, my gosh. I think it killed Peep. Well. Probably shouldn't continue now. Damn. Yeah, I have no idea what UAC is, actually. I'm like running, yeah, 8 or 7. I'm not sure which. Alright. Okay, we're gonna try to go around because those things killed Peep. There's also nothing set to essential in Morrowind, so you could possibly kill someone that is important to a questline, and there's nothing you can do about it. Loading area. Alright. Are we here? Oops. Follow me, Peep. Oh, I'm not on 8? Okay, so I'm probably on 7 then. Fields of Kamu? Yeah, his farmer could not get muck sponge without his guar. And could not provide muck for himself or his village. Here we go. Okay. Are we not at the Fields of Kamu then? No! Damn it! They have such a huge draw distance! Oh my gosh, and there's two of them. These Kigaudi. He's... They're gonna end up killing all the people. Oh my gosh. Okay, well. Alright. We're gonna have to try to skip them too. Holy crap. I mean, I guess I could just drop that lady off at that place, and then when I'm more powerful, find her later. Jeez. Morrowind is tough. Alright, are we... There we go! Thank you for your help, Dreitha. Here is the payment I promised you. May all of your travels be safe. There we go. Friggin' A. I don't know why she didn't go by this before. Alright, we are good. Alright, let's head back on our way. There's no way I can fight Kigaudis. I'm friggin' still level 1. By the way, level 1, 30 health. This game, it'll screw you over. Alright, let's heal a bit, just in case we come across more highway bandits and whatnot. Oh, look at the sky. That's friggin' nice. Yeah, I need some sort of enchantment to get me constant restore fatigue, because this is pretty nasty. Even having one extra regen would be nice. Oh my gosh, are you freaking serious? That is... Oh my gosh. That is another bandit highwayman. And it looks like the same friggin' guy, too. Stop attacking Peep. You killed... Fucking A. He killed Peep. No! Wait, I didn't want to save! Oh my gosh. Things are dangerous. Things are quite dangerous. Okay. I'm probably going to have to get another companion because Peep doesn't seem to take a lot of good hits. There we go. Goodbye. Sweet. Alright. Quick save. Let's also heal. Thank goodness. Alright. Now I've got to watch out for this other bandit highwayman, which is the third one we found at this intersection now. Kind of crazy. Yeah, I mean, dubstep cannons are usually the best, right? When you get to the MGSO step, the box freezes. So you're saying when it tries to activate the ESPs that go to MGSO? Combo, you know what would be good? Send me a few screenshots so I can see what you're, like, what you're looking at. Peep, please don't. The one where you pick the graphics settings. Oh, like, is it when it's, trying to do distant land? Because that does take a while. There we go. sure to give him all that stuff. Man, having a Guar is the best. We're probably gonna have to retire Peep because at this point I'm actually feeling a little bit guilty for getting him in combat so often. Let me see. The tab where you pick the settings you want. So we'll use the trees. Yeah, I'd have to go into the program to see exactly what that is. Darn. Alright, let's try to repair some more things then. My silver short sword takes a lot of damage here. I'm not going to heal that for one, so I think we're pretty good. Yes! Okay, so I know what menu you're talking about now. Yeah, red means high spec, green means low spec. Yeah. So... So it freezes up on you. Oh, you know what? The MGSO, like, installation actually requires some sort of weird automated mouse control. And so a lot of the stuff that you're going to actually choose will be automatically done through some weird mouse guiding technology, which I'm unaware of. But I think you might have to install some specific things or maybe even give it certain like account privileges or something like that. Because it essentially, like, once you activate certain things, it's supposed to like basically be like, all right, so you click this and then it like opens certain folders and does certain patches and the mouse moves on its own. It's pretty freaky, actually. It's kind of like it's possessed. Oh, yeah, Abacor, yeah. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to pay someone to repair my armor as well, so that's never a good thing either. So, by the way, I chose twisty trees. Do you guys like the twisty trees? I could choose dead trees, too. Oh my gosh, it's a freaking Nyxhound! Oh, okay, gotcha. You have to turn that off. Okay, gotcha. You're not attacking me, are you, Scoob? Crap, where am I in the Foyada now? But do you guys like the twisty trees? I thought they were very ominous. Oh yeah, yeah, definitely, yeah. If you're a wood elf, you're taught to maintain your bow, definitely. Here's Fort Frostmoth. If I wanted to get some very strange spells, I could go here. Yeah, in Valenwood, yeah. Actually, I'm wondering, maybe we could buy those spells now. Let's check that out. Oh gosh, lightning. And rain. Alright, Peep, I want you to stay out here. Sad beast groans.
You're on your honor. Don't press your luck.
Let's see. I think a lady down here sells some spells. No, not the prison towers. Right? Oh no, she does. Okay. Let's see what you have. Oh gosh, you have a lot of crazy things. Alright. Soul Pinch. Interesting. Bound stuff. Ah, drain spells. Yes. So, drain block is the spell you'd get. And then you can actually do a very cool exploit where you basically drain your skills to basically zero, and you can actually train your skills for one gold, or I think for free if you, they basically like take pity on you, like the people that train your skills in this game, if they're low enough. So it's pretty interesting. I won't actually be doing that, but that's pretty fun. I'm not really going to be doing anything with destruction spells though, so I'm going to care more about like, third berry is a little expensive for me, and those are kind of expensive. It was always kind of cool to see the different spells available. Let's hear it. That's one, if you want to have like some crazy overpowered thing, you do that. And then like you just go on a mental like friggin' like what training spree. Alright, follow me. To Balmora. Also, is it too dark? I haven't really heard an answer on that. Maybe it's okay. I'm just not used to it being this dark, but generally I play a game with a character who's self-enchanted like Nighteye permanently and some other crazy stuff as well, so there's also that to consider. Alright, we are in Balmora. We have a lot of stuff to sell, with Peep's help, there you are Peep, and a lot of other crazy stuff. Alright, so I think one of the things we want to go first to is let's head to this guy and see what we can get. I'll let Peep come in with me. I hate this guy, by the way. Let's see, companion share. I wish there was a take all key, but there's not. I have to actually go like this. But that's fine. I have so many things to sell to. Actually, you had one kite and arrow? That's kind of weird. Give me that. Gosh, Peep, really? Oh no, yeah, I was thinking that too, that if Peep is going to be someone who's following me around, then it would probably be a better idea for him to just like stay outside the dungeon. Oh, I totally agree with that. Yeah, because that is the thing in Morrowind, is that there's no they don't go unconscious, like that's just the thing, they will just flat out die. And that would become pretty annoying to be like, alright, I can't do this battle because Peep dies. So, no, I totally agree with that.
What is this about?
Alright. We need to barter. Ooh, is that a chitin tower shield? I think most of the stuff I want to sell. Oh, he doesn't buy pants. He also does buy that. Oh yeah, forgot about that. That's good though. Let's see. This is a bone mold stuff. That's medium. Most of my stuff is better. I think probably we need to upgrade to a chitin tower shield. Not too expensive. Otherwise, I think we're good. All the other stuff's netch leather. Chitin. So I think we're good there. Plus we have a lot of armor stuff already, and these are kind of expensive. So yeah, I think we're good there. Let me just sell my chitin shield as well. And let's increase that by like 15. Or 5 rather. Oof. He's a hard ass. 2 gold? There we go, jeez. Sweet. Now, funny thing, you... For some reason, merchants will actually wear what you sell them. So essentially, sometimes this guy will just like, if you sell enough stuff to him, he will wear like Dark Brotherhood armor and stuff.
There's the wizards. Anything out here? 25 gold.
Ooh, a lock level chest of 50. I don't think I can get that quite yet. Alright, we'll just have to deal. Beep! Beep, no! Beep! What's heal? Follow me. Alright, heal. I mean, peep. Alright, I just need you to move slightly. There! No! No! Peep! Peep, no! Peep, why? Alright, we're good now. And let's see what spells we can get. Because we definitely need some spells.
Speak quickly.
Actually, will they sell me spells if I'm not even part of the Mage's Guild yet? Or do they just refuse services? I'm not sure. Like, if I talk to you... Oh yeah, you can totally sell spells to me. Nice. Alright, so no destruction spells. Nice. Nice. Now, I have... I mean, I'm curious. So no, it doesn't come naturally. I will have to buy that. So let's definitely buy Paralysis. That is fantastic. Sound? I'm not sure if I care a lot about that. Burden's interesting. Feather. Feather's a good spell. What else do you have? Poison. Don't really care much about Burden, but that is awesome to get those two early on. What other spells can we get?
You have something to say to me?
Spells. Fire Shield. Ooh, Charming Touch. That's interesting. Ooh, Calm Creature and Calm Humanoid. Those are very good. We don't have Water Breathing, but we have Water Walking. Ooh, nice! Usudi's Open Door. Fantastic. That's going to be so useful for us. And Levitate. I think we need it. The earlier you get Levitate, just the better. It's just how it is. Yeah, I think that's definitely good to have. Spells, oddly enough, are going to cost the most for us. You sell spells as well? Yes. You have Feather. Spell Absorption. Actually, quite a high cost for that. What else do you have? Dispel. Spell is quite useful. Alright. I think we should probably save our gold, though, just in case we come across a good bow or something like that. That's pretty good, though. Oh, she sells...
What is this about?
Stuff. I doubt that we can get anything cool yet. It would be nice to figure out what is available. I think she gets different stuff, too. Interesting. Restore Fatigue. Wait, let me check that lady again. I need Restore Fatigue as a spell just in general so that I can have, like, the basis for an enchantment later. Did she have a Restore Fatigue spell, or was it mostly just Cure Common Disease, Restore Health, and Cure Poison? Yeah, alright. Never mind. Alright, sweet. I'm slowly starting to remember, like, the crazy things that have happened to us with companions in the past. I remember in Morrowind we had some interesting ones. Maybe this guy has some interesting stuff we can get? The Razor Hole? If they sell better bows, I definitely need them. Sells darts. We sells a crossbow. Yeah, you gotta go for it. I think the reload time's gonna be a pain in the ass, but I think it's gonna be a lot better to start using a crossbow. Yeah. Yabagor, nice. Alright, and silver bolts are quite a lot. Are there... we could... You know what? I'm going to keep the chitin bow, because I feel like we come across bolts a lot less often. Gosh, how much is that going to cost? It's going to be, like, a lot of money. We'll grab 50... We could paralyze and spell on self. That'd be pretty funny. Ooh! Oh, that's nasty. No, get them out of my inventory. What about steel bolts? Why is the cost so high? That should only be, what? 80? Alright, 86. So he's taking me for a little bit of a ride there. And then another 160. Alright, fine. Oh, I got away with murder there.
Don't stand about.
Sweet. Let me make sure that our steel crossbow is on here. Alright, inventory. Steel crossbow. So if we come across a harder enemy, we can start using a steel crossbow, especially if it's, like, enchanted and whatnot.
I can tell.
Can't open that. Oh yeah, we could open that dude with, or that part with the Sudanese open door. Alright, let me see. Actually, can I even cast it? I think if I had my fatigue back, I could.
I haven't much time.
Alright. Let's try and just like sort of sneak back here and see if I can't open that chest. Nice. Okay. Maybe. Alright, let's see. Failed to cast the spell. Nice. Now, the thing I have to remember is I can't sell this stuff to him. Actually, I'm gonna put that back. You think it's weird? Yeah, it is kind of weird how everybody in Morrowind is pretty hostile. I agree with that. No, yeah. Everybody in Morrowind, at least all the Dunmer, are xenophobes. They basically hate anybody who's not a Dunmer. It's absolutely true. And I'm not even joking around. Like, that's just the... That's what happens. That's how it is. I forget if there's any other good weapon shops. We might have to find them on our next trip. But yeah, let's talk to Caius Cassades, and, you know what? They have other spells at the temple. Although I feel like, what's my gold like right now? 300? Same in Windhelm. Let's talk to Caius Cassades, see if he can't give us some gold, and see what happens from there. What the? Oh, it's a piece of plant. Now, oh yeah! Wait a second. We can get our first home. Home. The interior that does not destroy things for you. If I can get into this house. Now the only issue is, I think people can see me. Spell unlock the target. Do I have a bounty? No. Hell yeah. Our new home! Hooray! And our illusion skill increased. Fantastic. Alrighty. Sweet. It's our new home. Hey! By trying to get past Peep, my acrobatics increased. Amazing. And we can level up. Let's do it. Let's rest until healed. Our first level up! You realize that all your life, you've been coasting along as if you were in a dream. Suddenly, facing the trials in the past few days, fuck yeah, you've come alive. Yeah, I know, right? Alright, we're definitely increasing agility, we're definitely increasing strength, and I think speed is something we definitely need for this character. Especially if we're going to be running away so often. Sweet. Peep, you are in the fucking way. Actually, Peep, I need you to, like, carry some things. I'm gonna wait till another town to sell some of this stuff because, like, these things are stolen items. They're kind of hot right now. So I have to wait for that to die off a little bit. Thank goodness he can just carry, like, an obnoxious amount of carry weight. Oh yeah, follow me. Okay, now Peep, I'm gonna have you wait outside, actually.
Right, what do you want?
Right here. Peep, 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 Peep over here. Teleport Peep. Good Peep. Alright. Stay. There we go. Athletics increased to 18, yeah. So we got a house too. Alright, let's talk to Caius Cassades. Alright. Yes, I'm Caius Cassades. But what do you mean you were told to report to Caius Cassades? What are you talking about? So you say your name is Dratha, and you've been told to report to me and deliver a package. Perhaps, let me look at it. Yes. Yes, very interesting. So it says here that the Ember wants me to mentor you. And that he means you'll be following my orders. Are you ready to trust me and to follow my orders, Dratha? Yes. Yabacord, nice. Let's see. Good, welcome to the service, Novice Dratha. You're now a member of the Imperial Blades. We are the Emperor's hidden eyes and ears in the provinces. We watch the Emperor's enemies and look for opportunities. We make reports, and when the Emperor commands, we obey. I'm the Imperial Spymaster for Morrowind. And while I'm the ranking Blades agent in Morrowind, you report to me. Follow my orders and obey our rules and you'll be fine. You can use my bed if you need rest, but leave my personal stuff alone unless I say otherwise. If you like, you can improve your modest skills with our Blades trainers now, or if you're in a hurry, I can give you orders right away. But don't forget to visit the Blades trainers. I just like Argonians because they're friggin' cool. I mean, there's nothing better than making a Godzilla character, and you basically just make an Argonian that's really good at destruction and, like, punching shit in the face. All I think they're really cool though, as like lore wise. I think they're really awesome. All right, Blades trainers. These Blades agents offer training, not free of course, but cheap for fellow agent. Look for Rithlin, Termalion, Nine Toes here in Balmora, in Caldera see Serene Lorraine, in Aldarun Gildan. Sorvar Horsemouth lives in a hut west of Aldarun, and alone the scout can be found at Ariel's Trade House in Sadenin. Alright, let's see. Mage Serene Lorraine is in Caldera, the next town north. Her half timber and stone house sits between the twin towers and the north gate of the governor's hall. Hey Phantom, how's it going? Where we've just met Kais Kasadis. We've traveled to Balmora. I got attacked by a Dark Brotherhood assassin on my first venture out of Sadenin. All the ancestral tombs were way too difficult. Hey Meow Guy, how's it going? But yeah, it was very strange because all of a sudden it was just like, so yeah, it's the first time you've like waited outdoors. Here's the Dark Brotherhood assassin for you. So that was fun. All right. So we're just meeting Kais Kasadis. I'm trying to get a lowdown on some of these Blades trainers. Let's see. Warrior Riflin lives two houses south upstairs. Nice. Oh, gotcha. Okay, cool. So you saw that then. Let's see. Let's go in order here. Healer, Termialin, lives two houses south downstairs. So they all live pretty close by, actually. Nine Toes. Okay, just getting all the journal updates here. To get to Hunter Nine Toes, leave my door facing south, go right down the stairs, and then left head south, looking for his door on your left. Why would the Dark Brotherhood come after you anyway? You know, I don't know. Normally, I think you're supposed to gather a carved ebony dart after them. Yeah, they need a reason to come after you, lore-wise, yes. I didn't get any, like, contracts or anything off of them, so I have no idea. All I know is that it's part of the Mournhold DLC, the Tribunal, so... That's all I know about it. I think we did Slytherin, right? Yeah. Gildan. Nightblade Gildan lives in Eldarun, in the Redoran district, near seat north of here, beyond Caldera. Gildan is in the southeast corner of town. Steps up to the temple. Okay. Oh my gosh, we have so many cats. So many cat emotes. Alright. And Savar Horsemouth. Let's see. Master-at-Arms Savor Horsemouth lives in a Gwar herder's hut in the middle of nowhere between Caldera and Aldarun. I've only been out there once, and couldn't give directions. Couldn't give you directions. Go look for him if you feel like a little hike. Alright. So just get the lowdown on all those trainers. You've over 50 cat emotes? Nice. Alright, let's see here. And let's grab... What was it? My orders. Alright, first thing, Pilgrim, you're new, and you look like it. Here's 200 drakes. Go get yourself a decent weapon or armor or a spell. And second thing, you're going to need to cover identity. Around here, a freelance adventurer is a common profession. Sign on with the Fighters Guild or Mages Guild or Imperial Cult or Imperial Legion to advance in the ranks and gain skills and experience. Or you could go out looking for freelance work or trouble. Then, when you're ready, come back to me. I have orders for you. Alright, let me see. Freelance work? Okay, you can always wander around, hunt for monsters. Okay, so that's basic stuff. Alright, so we're definitely going to... Let's join the Mages Guild, and then maybe see if we can join the Morag Tom. It might be that it's either level locked or, like, some other things, so I just want to check those out so that we're at least involved in... the quest lines that make sense for us. Mages, thieves, and assassins. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Chom. Is that all you say? What do you want? A little advice. If possible, always take a single item at a time. Increase the risk, but it's excellent practice. Let's see. South wall. Yes, this is the south wall. Let's see. A little advice. Let's see. If you want to know a place on Vardenfell, talk to a scout. And the scout I'd talk to is alone. You'll find her at Ariel's trade house in Sadenin. She's traveled all over the island.
Go ahead.
Are you looking for me? You want to join the Thieves Guild? Oh my gosh, yes I do! You look like you may have some skill. You want to join, or maybe you want to know what we're all about. Let's hear the rules, actually. Just remember that there is honor among thieves. Do not steal from a brother thief. Everyone else is a mark. Do not attack a brother thief. Do what you will to everyone else. If you have a price on your head, we have ways of taking care of it. If you break these rules, we must speak with one of the other masterminds here in Vardenfell to regain your good standing. Think you can handle it? Yes. All right. You are now a toad in the Thieves Guild. Welcome, Sister Dreitha. Talk to me if you want some odd jobs to do when you think you're ready for advancement. If you have a price on your head, there are those you can talk with as well. What's a good class to play as? I'd say... Really, Phantom? That's weird. So they refused to hire you. That's weird. I'd say Convoy, that one of the, like a something at least, like if you're getting into Morrowind. Oh my gosh, what? That's, why is Windows 10 so finicky? But yeah, I would suggest that, like, you can make your own class. I'd suggest, like, early on in Morrowind, if you kind of are not so happy with the fact that, like, you will miss opponents even if you're right next to them. Let's see. Yeah, probably Warrior. I would use, definitely add Destruction and Restoration as part of your skill set, though, because you can't miss with Destruction spells. That's just it. You can't miss. It's a fantastic thing. There's no, like, you miss with those spells. Even ranged, and especially with explosions. Plus, the customization is beautiful. I would also say, yeah, that Restoration's incredibly useful. You have to. I mean, you could rely on items, but you gotta have spells. Alright, let's see here. Let's see if we can get a job. A good friend from Habasi wants a diamond. Naclara the Alchemist has diamonds. Alright. A friend wants a diamond from Habasi. Naclara of Whitehaven had diamonds last time. Habasi sniffed out the store. Bring Habasi a diamond. Okay, cool. So we have to get a diamond. Yeah, it's true. You can always make anything work, really. It's very true. Because you can customize it any way you want. Basically, the way that I make a Morrowind character is...
What Khajiit do for you?
What skills am I going to use the most of? And then you make a class around that. And it's the best way to do it. Like, for instance, I'm always going to shoot things. Light armor, sneaking, illusion. Actually, how's my sneak? I feel like it's going to be very difficult to upgrade sneak for my character. But, like, these are all things I'm going to use. And basically everything that you're not going to use, just have them as miscellaneous skills. It's literally the coolest thing ever. And, you know, the things you want the most of, use as a major skill. It's the best. Alright. So we have to bring her a diamond. Now, Claria of Whitehaven. Alright. I'm just going to join a few guilds. And try to get some other things. So let's also join the Mages Guild. join the Mages Guild? Yes, you look like the sort we could use the Mages Guild. Will you take the Mages Oath and join the Mages Guild? Yes. You are now a member of the Mages Guild. Welcome, associate. When you're ready, you can ask for duty super form, and once you're ready, you can ask me about advancement. I don't have any duties for an associate. Speak to me again when you've proven yourself. In the meantime, speak with Ajira. I believe she has a small task for you. All right, let's get a thing from Ajira.
How interesting.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, yeah, Fallout 4 contraptions came out today. So, yeah, that's a thing.
Outlander, what do you want?
All right, let's see. Duties. Yes, Ajira's duties for you. Before Ajira can be a journeyman in the Mages Guild, must study local mushrooms. Okay. To finish Ajira's report, Ajira needs samples of Luminous Russula, Violet Corpinus, Bugler's Bane, and Hypha Fascia. Ajira knows you will find all these in the Bitter Coast. The easiest way is to go along the river of Odai. I think that's right. No, I understand, convoy. Computers can be rough sometimes. Yeah, Windows 10 is... Yeah, I know. Did yours auto-update into Windows 10? Because that is the fucking worst. Luckily, my computer... I think I actually shut off Windows updates completely, so I don't even get Windows updates anymore. But yeah, I've heard a lot of people complain that their computer auto-update. Yes, exactly, yeah. So, like... Yeah, your Windows 7 mysteriously deleted itself. Exactly. So basically what it did was it somehow updated into Windows 10 without you knowing. It was just disguised as an update. Wait, it deleted part of your operating system? Well, shit. Wow, I thought it just updated everything to Windows 10. Weird shit, though. Gotta say, I wouldn't have done it that way. All right. Let's see. Until you meet a wooden bridge across the river, get up the river there, and you'll find a small path to the hills. Sweet. So we've got a steel and diamond, collect mushrooms.
So what do you want?
Oh, you had no up. Wait, what? Oh, wait, so you had no operating system on your computer for a little while? That's... Now that's weird. That is really weird. No, yeah, fuck them for trying to force us into, something we didn't want, exactly. Alright, the Morog Tongue Guild. You're walking really fast. Darath. Oh, that's a companion. I thought he was walking around too quickly. Let's see. Nope, you're not talking to me about joining... the guild. I mean, I'm dressed for the part. What do you sell? Oh, lockpicks. Let's see. So your name is Dreitha, and you're here in Balmora. Well, my name is Angeran. And I don't mind answering questions. What else do you have in mind? Or what else do you have on your mind right now? If I start to worry about Morwen lore, just let me know. Alright. The Clara of Whitehaven. Her shop is a two-story building to the northwest side of town. Interesting. That's weird.
Make it quick, Outlander.
Ooh, level 95 in trap.
Speak, traveler.
Alright, welcome, Adretha. What brings you to the Morog Tongue? The Morog Tongue is an ancient traditional assassin's guild of the Dunmer. We provide three varieties of execution, public, private, and house war. We also recruit candidates of proven skill and honor. Only Grandmaster Inu Halulu in Vivek can authorize new members to join the Morog Tongue. Interesting. Okay, so I'm going to write that down. Join Morag Tongue in, let's see, Vivek. Sweet. All right, cool. So that's definitely a mission we're going to do eventually. Faction members only. Damn it. All the good stuff. Actually, I think... Fine. Wait. Oh, hey! That's right, F in here. Might as well. You know what we need? Ooh. Oh. We need telekinesis. Blue agit ring. 4 gold, no. Rest until healed.
There is no escape.
Oh my gosh, are you freaking serious? Guard! Guard, help me! Guard! Guard! Please! There's a man attacking me! Guard! There's an assassin after me! Please! Please help me! What the hell, man? I don't have enough magicka. Oh my gosh, what in the fuck? How did you let an assassin in the building? What's the use of a town guard that doesn't help you? Help me! This is the second time today! I heard they're reforming the Morhug Tongue! I think that, yeah, that guard might have taken a contract. Oh my gosh. So, can I, like, just sort of, like, quick save? Yeah, were you been attacked by the Dark Brotherhood? No way! Twice today! Actually, can I use a, one more of these? Don't have enough magicka, of course I don't. Oh my gosh, give me a break. Thank you. All right, I might be able to cheese this guy. Give him the runaround. Quiet now. Finally!
What, Outlander? Why do you disturb me?
You're terrible at your job. You. Save being attacked by assassins? From your description, it sounds like the Dark Brotherhood. I'm not sure who you angered, but stay away from me. I don't suppose this should be officially reported, although I'd speak to Aphelous Mattias and Ebo. I'm not sure. You recently arrived in Cyrodiil. You're likely to find him inspecting the grounds at Ebonheart. Does that mean they'll stop attacking me now? Or is that not a thing? There we go, there's the diamonds we needed. He's just afraid for his family, give him a break. I mean, you're right. Oh shit, I forgot we have a crossbow. We could handle that guy though. Now I wonder, is any of this better than what we have? Not really. I mean, I could repair some of it, I suppose. I'm gonna go to the Mamor Temple, see what spells we can buy here. And what we can steal, because of course, that's what we do. I'm surprised I haven't gotten any critical attacks yet, or critical strikes or anything like that. Let's see, barter? What do you sell? Ooh! You sell enchanted shields. Interesting. Shield of Light, Velothian Helmet, Velothian Shield, and a Velothian Tower Shield. The armor rating is not as good though. Actually, can you buy some of this weird stuff for me? Yeah, you can. Can you buy armor too? Oh, holy shit. So I forgot that Dark Brotherhood stuff is actually incredibly expensive. Breaking bank with assassins. Oh gosh. Okay, we're getting close on his bartering here. Let's go for one more glove. No, let's take out a the greaves. Add a pauldron. Oh my gosh. Every time we kill an assassin, we're gonna get like a lot of gold. Holy crap. Yeah, there we go.
What do you want?
Now, one of the things I want to do is I actually want to invest in a spell that increases their, like a charming spell and like a fortify personality spell on self would be amazing. Barter. You sell potions. Alright, I don't care so much. Alright. Actually, I might sneak for this. Sometimes these crates have, like, really good random stuff, like soul gems and whatnot. Actually, didn't I get a soul gem earlier? An enchanted hammer! Shard Mauler. Exclusive restore willpower. Holy crap, sometimes these chests, like, the randomness of them is just incredible. By the way, first episode, we have 13,000 gold. Holy crap. You are a companion? Cool. A companion that has spell making. So how expensive would a... Let's see. How expensive? Whoa, not 500. Okay, so I have a spell chance of 0, so it doesn't even friggin' matter at this point. Actually, if I go to... I just want to know, like, for reference. If I want to buy... Interesting, it's going to cost 420 gold to get an open spell on 100. And the spell chance is 10. And I don't even think I have enough magic to cast it. Good to know. All right, spells. See, soul traps, they're always good. These cost a lot. Sheldor's Mirror, why are these so... Ooh, recall, yes. Elm Civi Intervention, resist blight, resist magic, fortify health. I need a restore fatigue spell. Cure paralysis. By the way, how does cure paralysis work? Aren't you paralyzed? Like, that makes no sense. Let's see, absorb fatigue. They cost so much because she hates you. That, you're right, that does affect it. Alright, let's see. You fixed it? Nice. Divine aid, fortify willpower and luck. Wisdom, fortify intelligence, endurance. Nice! We got mark and recall. We got mark and recall. Oh, what do you have, by the way? Actually, I probably don't want to barter with you because I stole some things.
Whatever yes. You're looking for, I'm sure I don't know
how to. I will listen, Outlander, but make it quick.
Sweet. We have mark and recall already. And I think, can I cast them? Oh gosh. The chance is very low. Granted, my fatigue isn't all the way up, but still. Oh, thanks for the follower. Half the alphabet, thank you. Training. No, I'm not going to join
whatever
the temple.
For, I'm sure I don't know how to find it.
Do you sell things? Ah, you do have spells. Absorb fatigue. I need yes, here we go. Restore fatigue. Excellent. And restore health. You know what? I'll get it. Restore intelligence and all that. And restore free companion. Okay, cool. Nice. You have anything? Yeah, just potions and stuff. I can probably get some level ups from reading a few of these things. Let's just see.
Say what you want or go away.
Nice. Unarmored increased to 8. If you could just pay attention over here, and then I'll just sort of like just go behind you a little bit. Actually, let me quick save to make sure this works. Nope, that didn't work. Okay, I'll just read them and put them back. Didn't realize I needed a temple library card. My bad. My bad.
Yes, sir.
Pilgrim's Path. Okay, my journal has updated. I don't know what you get for this thing, but Pilgrim's Path is interesting. Spear increased to 6. Nice. Alright, so let me check my journal entry for this. I've read the Pilgrim's Path, and I've marked the location of each shrine on my map. Oh, okay, cool. So... Yeah, we've got a few different locations. Awesome. Now, granted. A few locations on my map, and it's Vardenfell, and there's the rest of Morrowind. So that's fun. Alright, sweet. I think I've gotten everything I want then. We've even like done half of a quest already. Or most of it. Alright then, cool. Let's stop there for the day. We've done a great deal today. I mean, hell. If you would have told me that by the end of my first session I would have Dark Brotherhood armor and I'd have, well, I did have 13,000 gold at one point, I would have thought you were crazy. But no, that's just how the cookie crumbles in this case. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll come back tomorrow, where we will do some more quests for the Thieves Guild and Mages Guild, and I guess eventually find the Morog Tong, and talk to Caius Cassades and see what else he wants us to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and yeah, I will see you guys next time. I will see you guys, yeah, then. Bye. Oh, thanks for the follow.